This week on Community Connection, a Disney on Ice performance of Toy Story 3 comes to the Citizens Business Bank Arena, and audiences are excited to tell us all about their favorite characters. A new art exhibit opens at the Orange Show, and the community comes out in a show of support for local artists. As part of our special series, we showcase San Bernardino's Mayor Pat Morris, his family, and their role in San Bernardino's Beautification Partnership. We'll take a look at all the fun activities that Yucaipa Regional Park has to offer patrons. We've got exclusive tryout coverage of Ontario's newest indoor football league, the Warriors, all during Sports Watch. Later on in the show, we'll highlight a local furniture store that has a touch of home, a touch of class, and most of all, great prices. And Nadia Gill, our entertainment guru, has a great East Street ticket lined up for this week's show. This is Community Connection. I'm Laura Paredes. Disney made some dreams come true for audiences when they brought Toy Story 3 on ice to the Citizens Business Bank Arena. Families proved what a coveted classic the latest Toy Story installment is by talking about their favorite characters. Let's check it out.
Welcome to the Citizens Business Bank Arena. Tonight we all have the opening of Toy Story 3.
Toy Story 3 is my favorite Disney movie.
I think it's just very funny. The characters, Woody, Buzz,
The show contributes back to the first movie, the second, and then we also have a third movie as well. So we have lots of characters coming back into town, and it's a really fun production.
My favorite character is Bullseye.
I love Bullseye because he's like a dog, and he's awesome.
And he's my favorite because he wins a lot and I win a lot.
I love Jessie because she's cool.
Because she's strong and adventurous.
I like Jessie because she has great food.
My favorite character is Buzz.
Buzz as well, because he can fly, and I wish I could fly.
My favorite part as an ensemble skater is Woody's Roundup. It's just a fun, thrilling number that we get everyone up out of their seats, and it's really, really fun.
So we actually came to the Disney on Ice show, where it featured all the different attractions from the Disneyland park.
Kids love Disney on Ice, anything that's on ice, so we just decided to surprise them and bring them.
I think it promotes community because it brings people together at our local businesses here, and we're able to share experiences with our neighbors and co-workers and our families in a place just down the street.
If you come with your family, you're definitely going to enjoy it, especially if you have kids.
I encourage everyone to come out and see the show because tickets only start at $15, and even if you're not sitting front row, we entertain from all the way up.
You're missing out on seeing Disney come alive on ice. Every aspect of the movie, it's just so exciting to see it on ice, and the performers and the lighting, and it's just a great ambiance, and it's just a great experience, way different than being at the amusement park. You're actually in the movie. We love Toy Story!
We love Toy Story 3.
I love Toy Story.
God, friend.
We open tonight, December 28th, and the shows run through January 1st. For more information about our show, you can go to DisneyOnIce.com or Ticketmaster for show times and ticket prices.
The arena is not only host to our favorite hockey team, the Ontario Reign, but tons more events like this. You can go to their website at www.cbbankarena.com for their event calendar. Woody and Buzz may have taken over the big screen and now the ice, but they also took over a preschool. During our next show, we'll show you exclusive coverage of the Toy Story takeover of Redlands Day Nursery. But right now, let's check out the opening of the Orange Show art exhibit. Finally, local artists are able to unveil their sculptures and paintings to the community. Let's watch.
Welcome to the opening of the National Orange Show Art Gallery in downtown San Bernardino. The theme for this exhibition, of course, is the permanent collection of the Orange Show dating back to 1949.
I think it's a very lovely collection of California art.
This gallery will help the community in that it will provide a venue for a lot of fine artists in our community to have an opportunity to exhibit their works. For more information, contact Ernie Garcia at 888-6788. Come here and visit and see what's going on.
Another exhibit will soon be unveiled on March 8th. To learn more about San Bernardino's National Orange Show Art Gallery, you can give them a call at 909-888-6788. Speaking of San Bernardino, David Avery is here and he's brought us another installment of the Beautification Partnership Series. Right, David?
That's right, Laura. City of San Bernardino connected with its residents in a joint initiative to beautify their city. Community groups, organizations, churches, and everyday people got together to take part in a citywide cleanup. We documented their efforts as a part of our special Beautification Partnership Series. This week, we feature Mayor Pat Morris and his family. Let's watch as they give Wildwood Park a minor facelift.
I am at the entry of Wildwood Park, 40th and Waterman Avenue. We are several hundred people in this park working to beautify the park, taking out a bunch of plants and dead grass. We've just repainted the sign, Wildwood Park. The grandchildren painted that. So you see the handiwork of little children as well as the handiwork of men and women. We have a city website. Just go to that website, pick and choose an area that you'd like to work in or adopt, and we can have you committed to that.
That's not something you see every day. The mayor getting in there, getting his hands dirty. He wasn't uncomfortable doing so?
Not at all. I mean, he was out there hacksawing palm trees that were like 20 feet tall and putting them in the dumpsters, and even his granddaughter was jumping in there, smashing it all down. I mean, it sure was a sight to see. They're working pretty hard.
How did he get involved with the project?
Well, just like everybody else, he signed up, and he is now committed to the upkeep and sustainability of the front of the Wildwood Park.
Why just the front? Why the facade? Why not the entire park?
Well, Laura, I don't know if you've been to the Wildwood Park, but it's pretty big. Too big for one man and his family to keep up. So there's organizations, church groups, students, and even everyday people that are there that are also contributing.
What else did the Morris family do?
Well, the Morris family, they replaced roses and palm trees with more plants that didn't take as much water. So pretty much, I mean, as beautiful as they are, roses and palm trees, it costs a lot to have the upkeep for them. So they replaced them.
You know what, that's smart, and I never really thought of that. Let's remind everyone out there how they can get involved with the Beautification Partnership.
Sure. It's gonna kick back off again in April. So to sign up for a project area, go to the city's website at www.sbcity.org and stay connected.
Thanks, David, for stopping by.
No problem.
Up next on Community Connection, we've got exclusive coverage of the Ontario Warriors tryouts at Rialto High School. Then the Auto Club Speedway in Fontana hosts a junior drag racing event. But right after this break, we've got a sneak peek into the life of student athlete Casper Chereau from Carter High School. Stay connected, folks.
You're watching Inland Empire Media Group. Contact us for opportunities to grow your business at 909-384-5285. That's 384-5285.
When it comes to high school senior Casper Chereau, a move to wrestling may have began on a whim, but what he has gained is a mental endurance that he feels not everybody has. Let's take a look at the player profile of Casper Chereau.
My name is Casper Chereau. I'm a senior, and I go to Carter High School. The way I wrestle at is 126, and the most difficult part about wrestling is probably the mental toughness of wrestling. Some people just can't handle it. I came to the sport because I had an older cousin who wrestled, and I just got tired of playing basketball, so I just decided to wrestle. The funnest part for me is walking on the mat and just dominating someone, just having fun. For practice, we normally start off with a couple, like a technique for about 30 minutes, and then we do conditioning here. You know, it varies. For conditioning, we do suicides, we do bear crawls, we do hopovers, we just do everything. For technique drills, we just shoot our doubles, shoot our singles, shoot our high Cs, just over and over and over and over again, shoot different finishes, you know. I mean, most of our practice is the end of practice when you're walking away and your shirt is just drenched. I like that feeling the most. the most difficult part about being a student and athlete, right, doing homework, because after you get home from practice, you just beat. You're just like, I want to go to sleep, but nah, you got to do it. The most important thing I'll take away from Coach Hennessy is always give, you know, because he's always gave to me, you know, even like off-season tournaments, like I didn't have money, he's like, oh, all right, just because I showed up, I want to get better, so just always give, like, just keep it open, you know. He likes to see determination, you know, and just that you're willing to get better, and he'll help you at all costs. He'll go out of his way to help you.
Casper's been wrestling with us. He came out as a ninth grader, and he's been with us all 4 years. And Casper works really hard. He's done a lot of the extra stuff in the off season to prepare himself to become the wrestler that he is right now. He won a league title as a sophomore and took second last year. But you know, I really expect him to win a league title again this year and go a lot further. I really expect him to be a CI placer and probably qualify for state.
The biggest influence in my life, I'll have to say my grandma. Because she took me in when I was a little kid, so I just learned everything in life from her, basically. Like, she raised me, so. I like to say thank you to my grandma and to Coach Hennessy, of course, and all the other coaches, Coach Lope, and everyone who's helped me along my way, you know, helped me learn.
What we can clearly see is that Casper lives in an attitude of gratitude for all those who have helped and inspired him along the way. After seeing this, I'm in the mood for Sports Watch. Caitlin Eden is out on assignment at the moment, but we've got that exclusive Warrior tryout footage right now. Athletes came from as far as Orange County and throughout the Inland Empire to Rialto High School for a chance to make the only professional football team in the IE, including former National League player R.J. Soward. Let's check it out.
Today we're at Rialto High School doing our first open tryout for the Ontario Warriors in the Indoor Professional Football League in Citizens Bank Arena.
When we first started off with a lap to warm everybody up and get the joints loose, did our jumping jacks. We did high knees, and we also did three-quarter speed sprints. And after that, we did another drill called the shuttle. Then we jumping into our one-on-ones. We're just trying to get a good feel on how each position moves.
A lot of the guys have been playing outdoor football. Today, they're getting their first chance to ever play indoor football.
Indoor football, your big difference is we play on a 50-yard football field versus a 100-yard football field. In outdoor NFL, there's 11-on-11. In our league, there's 8-on-8. The local talent is important because, you know, the friends and the family come out to support, you know, the people are familiar with some of these guys that are local.
My mom hasn't seen me play since 2004. I have four boys, and they're going to get a chance to see their dad play, and I'm very happy to be a part of this because it is my home, it is my turf, and all my friends and all my family will get to see me play. There's no football from here to San Francisco or to San Diego.
Instead of family drive 45 an hour to go see the Dodgers around springtime or Staples Center to watch the Lakers, it's something here locally.
This area has been, you know, itching for football, and this is the opportunity for everybody to come out, have a great time, see something different. It's something that everybody can be a part of, and the kids will love it, fans will love it. You know, it's going to be an exciting time this year, and we're going to win the championship.
We definitely need the local support to make this championship run. It's very important that we fill up the arena.
I heard there's 10 million people in the Inland Empire. That's a lot of people. Hopefully we can get them all to come out.
You know, we want to be here a long time, and it's going to take community support and local support for us to have longevity here in the area.
We're going to give the people the best show that they have ever seen. We're going to go out there, we're going to play hard, and like I said, we're going to win a championship. For information and to get season tickets, stop by www.ontwarriors.com. We'll see you at the game.
The team has been solidified and their season is about to take off. Game day schedule and tickets are available on their website at www.ontwarriors.com. I don't know about you, but the thought of an 8-year-old child going 80 miles per hour on a racetrack terrifies me. That's just the type of thrill that junior drag racers from ages 8 through 17 can enjoy at the Auto Club Speedway in Fontana. Let's watch.
Today we're at Auto Club Dragway, and this is our Junior Dragster program. So the Junior Dragster program happens about 10 times a year. We have kids from
age 8 all the way up to 17.
I've been racing for 8 years. Favorite part is hanging out with my family and friends.
Girls can definitely do anything boys can do. I had a pink car, so when you beat a boy, it's fun because they don't like it.
I've been doing it about 15 years. I do it for the passion of the sport. If you want to have fun and keep your children with you on the weekend, come drive me.
For more information, you can call 909-429-5000 or you can go to www.autoclubspeedway.com.
Listen, if your child has the need for speed, you can learn more about the junior drags at the Speedway's website at www.autoclubspeedway.com. Up next on Community Connection, we take a look at the Home Gallery Furniture Store in San Bernardino. We get some meaningful insight into child abuse and prevention during a moving tribute called the Lisa Project. But right after this break, we take a closer look at Yucaipa Regional Park. Stay tuned. You're watching Community Connection.
I'm RJ Sauer with the Ontario Warriors. You're watching Community Connection. Get connected, stay connected. Holla.
Today we're at Yucaipa Regional Park, which is one of several in San Bernardino County. The lakes are all man-made. It was built in 1981, and we have camping, tent, and RV. We have the Three Lakes Swim Complex, and today we're having a fishing derby and the whole fishing program at Yucaipa Regional Park. Get out of the house, get away from the phone, come here, throw a line in, and just forget about it. Just relax. That's, I think, the biggest thing we offer. If you would like to come to Yucaipa Regional Park, the street address is 33900 Oak Glen Road in the city of Yucaipa.
This park is massive. There are over 100 acres for folks to enjoy with all the wildlife and nature around, like bald eagles, herons, bobcats, and coyotes. Oh my! It's hard to imagine that much of it, including the lakes, are man-made. Yucaipa Regional Park is the complete package with all its outdoor amenities, such as camping, fishing, and even golfing. If you would like to take advantage of the recreational activities at this park for yourself, they are located at 33900 Oak Glen Road in Yucaipa. For more information on any of the regional parks, visit www.sbcountyparks.com. I was on the market for a new couch, but I really wanted to shop local. That's when I came across the Home Gallery Furniture Store. Take a look.
Once you first walk into Home Gallery, we see a very high-end, expensive furniture. We offer better quality at very low prices. Home Gallery, we offer a variety of style of furniture from dining, bedroom to living room. We have jewelry boxes, picture frame, lamps, nightstands, coffee table, end table. You can pick out a casual dining or a formal dining table. Any name brand that you can think of, we can offer it for you. Most of them is local here within Southern California. Customer doesn't have to have a designer. We can help them to decorate the way they like. Just pick out the color and then manufacturer will be able to custom the way that you want. You can finance the furniture. The layaway is pretty much very easy. If you need a delivery service, we have our own truck. Home Gallery is unique because we care about the consumer need. We offer a great service for them, make sure that they're happy and satisfied with their products that they purchase here at Home Gallery. Customer come in and find the furniture that they like and walk out happy with the purchase, and they always seem like they call back and say thanks, and that's what makes me happy. Home Gallery located at 999 Southeast Street. Our phone number is 909-889-5655. We offer low prices and a customer service satisfaction guarantee.
shopping locally is a great way to boost your local economy, and it can be an adventure to check out your neighborhood mom and pop shops. A great way to help children is by raising awareness for child abuse, which is just what the Lisa Project aims to do. The Arrowhead Regional Medical Center in Colton hosted this moving exhibit, which encouraged the community to help stop the violence. Let's watch.
Today we're at the Lisa Project, located in Colton at the Arrowhead Regional Medical Center. The Lisa Project is a multi-sensory interactive exhibit about child abuse prevention and awareness. And the idea is that everybody who comes to the Lisa Project hears a different form of abuse and a different child's story. Each room in the exhibit that represents a different child's story is based on a real child. It's a good way to let people know what's going on in the community. For more information about the Lisa Project, you can check out the website at www.thelisaproject.org.
If you'd like more information on this powerful exhibit, please visit their website at www.thelisaproject.org. Up next on Community Connection, we've got some groundbreaking news for San Bernardino and the future of transportation. Mary Roan will show us what she has in store for upcoming connections. But right after the break, Nadia Gill brings us East Street Ticket. Stay connected, folks.
You're watching Inland Empire Media Group. Contact us for opportunities to grow your business at 909-384-5285. That's 384-5285.
Thanks for coming back. Our local theater venues have had a fantastic season, and this week Nadia gives us an inside view of a performance of Jekyll and Hyde at the Sturgis Center. Roll it!
Hello, I'm Nadia Gill, and welcome to your East Street Ticket. Tonight, we bring you your local arts and entertainment update from the Sturgis Center to watch the first show of the season, Jekyll and Hyde, the musical. But first, let's ask the director to tell us more about tonight's show.
It is a thriller musical based upon the novel by Robert Louis Stevenson. We pulled together a 20-person cast. They are absolutely phenomenal. I have a 12-person production team that come from Walt Disney Company, Broadway. They're amazing. You can expect just a wonderful piece for the Halloween season.
I can't wait to watch tonight's show. As for the audience, they were taken into the streets of London to explore the many sides of good and evil. But let's go to the audience to get their reaction of tonight's show.
It was absolutely phenomenal. I'm just so impressed with the talent in this cast. It's just amazing.
The harmonies are amazing, and the singers, they're really good. I really, really enjoyed it.
I thought visually it was amazing. I really liked the set. And the live music is really cool.
The audience came in for a fun time and left the Sturgis Center wanting more. If you would like to know where we're going to be next, go ahead and like our Facebook page. But always remember, stay cultured, my friends.
If you want to know more about the Sturgis Center and their shows, go to their website at www.sturgiscenter.org. San Bernardino gets on board with the future of transportation with the new light rail system called SBX by Omnitrans. Let's take a look at the ribbon-cutting ceremony.
We're here for the groundbreaking ceremony for the SBX East Street Rapid Transit Corridor. This effort has been going on for some time, and this is a major milestone.
We're very excited about the new SBX. Coming onto campus, we're hoping that that brings a lot more students to campus, opens up opportunities.
This is going to benefit many, many people. And as you can see, the people that have spoken here have given us a lot of support, anywhere from the community to the federal government.
And then be able to deliver projects like this that benefit the grassroots element of our community, and that is the people.
Let's get on board.
It's the next step to making San Bernardino a vibrant city as it was once before. For more information, you can contact 855-SBX-NEWS.
We'll be delivering you updates and progress of this new system as they occur, so stay connected. But right now, Mary Roan has some great things in store for upcoming connections. Mary Roan?
Thanks, Laura. We've got a fantastic lineup for next week's show, including country recording artist Phil Vassar.
He stops by the California Theater and sings some of his top hits, including That's Why I Love You and my personal favorite, The Hot Tub Song. The Ontario Ring gets armed with the American Red Cross. They'll be sporting specially designed jerseys by the famed LA Ink tattoo artist Corey Miller. The symbol of the Phoenix rising from the flames and ashes is on these jerseys, which will be auctioned off, with the proceeds going to the Inland Empire chapter of the American Red Cross. Magnolia at Highland is a new affordable senior apartment complex that's just opened. The amenities they have make them seem like a vacation getaway that's just close enough to their families. We'll bring you exclusive coverage of the ribbon-cutting ceremony of this local oasis. And of course, we'll bring you another installment of the San Bernardino Beautification Partnership Series, which will feature the Native Sons of the Golden West. The Native Sons is an organization that takes great pride in the history of California and San Bernardino, and we'll get a chance to see their efforts. If you want to be a part of our show, go to our website and check out our upcoming stories. You just might be a part of next week's show. Get connected, stay connected. That's it for me. Back to you, my dear.
Thanks, Mayor. You heard it here first. We've got a great show to look forward to next week. Coming up next, it's the Final 40. Come on back to Community Connection. As you can see, there's a lot of fun and exciting things going on throughout your community. If you'd like more info about what you've seen today, go to our website at www.iemediagroup.tv/community for the full stories, videos, and photos. You can also connect with us on Facebook and Twitter. Until next time, I'm Laura Paredes, and this is Community Connection. Get connected, stay connected.